Now, the Greens have accused both major parties of conspiring against them after they ruled out doing deals to form a minority government. It could mean Australians return to the polls if the September 7 election is tight. In a moment, we'll speak to the only Greens MP left in the lower house, Adam Bandt. But first, here's Ursula Hager.
Kevin Rudd was dishing it up in Brisbane at the Royal Ecker Show and copping a serve of his own.
Your balls are a bit small there, sir.
I'm sorry about that.
Back for another bite in the state that's dominating the election campaign.
He's doing a good job. Don't let the others get here.
No, mate, I don't intend to.
But it wasn't the only place where he found support. Tony Abbott announcing the coalition will preference Labor above the Greens in every electorate.
This is my captain's call, and I say to Mr Rudd, be man enough to do the same.
He also ruled out leading a minority government, meaning Australians could go back to the polls if there's a tight finish.
The last 3 years has been a litany of betrayals, of broken promises, of disappointed hopes.
He cannot govern without the Nationals. So this is all just hot air from Tony Abbott.
It was Liberal preferences that helped the Greens over the line in Melbourne. Now the seat could go back to Labor. Kevin Rudd also took aim at Labor's former partner.
There'll be no coalition arrangements with either the Greens or minor parties. Furthermore, no negotiated agreements, as you've seen in the past.
A day after Mr Abbott's sex appeal gaffe, his daughter was defending him.
Another dorky dad moment, that's all.
But the opposition leader was again on the back foot over comments on radio about gay marriage.
I'm not someone who wants to see radical change based on the fashion of the moment.
Good on you.
To describe sexual orientation as the fashion of the moment, it will be deeply offensive.
Mr Abbott's gay sister told her Twitter followers he wasn't speaking for her. He tried to clarify.
I certainly think that it's a very significant issue. It's a very significant issue.
Both leaders will be giving Queensland voters a brief respite tomorrow. Mr Rudd making his first visit of the campaign to the Northern Territory, while Tony Abbott will take off to Tasmania.
Ursula Hager reporting there. Joining us now is the MP for Melbourne, Adam Bandt. Mr Bandt, how much of a blow is this to your chances?
I don't think it'll make that much of a difference. We've always presumed since day one that Labor and the Coalition had reached some kind of accommodation on preferences in an attempt to try and get us out and make sure there aren't third voices in the Parliament. So our campaign since getting elected has been based around growing our primary vote and being returned in our own right, regardless of what the others do on preferences. And the indications are that if we keep working hard over the next few weeks, we're on track to do exactly that.
You were only elected in 2010 with the help of Liberal preferences. What makes you so sure that you won't need them again?
Well, in 2010, we had 36% of the people in Melbourne voting for the Greens, and that was on the back of 1.6 million people around the country saying that they wanted an alternative progressive voice in Parliament. The analysts say, and have come out and said today, that if we can grow our vote, which grew by 13% last time, by somewhere in the order of 4 or 5% this time, then we're in a position to hold the seat regardless of what the others do on preferences. And the closer we get to the election and the more that Kevin Rudd tries to out-Abbott Tony Abbott on the question of refugees, the more that we see cuts to university funding, to climate change programs, the more people are coming to me and saying that they want a clean economy and a caring society, and they're switching the vote to the Greens, and that gives me some confidence.
So you're taking all this as a compliment, but you must admit it doesn't do your party any favours losing preferences.
Well, look, when Tony Abbott comes out and says, look, what I'd really like is a Labor backbencher representing the seat of Melbourne rather than the Greens' Adam Bandt because he's having too much influence, I do see that as a bit of a badge of honour. I'll probably be putting it on my campaign materials. And what Tony Abbott knows is that a Labor backbencher will vote with him to cut single-parent payments or to cut university funding or to engage in the race to the bottom on refugees and vote to keep people in detention indefinitely. And they know the Greens won't, which is why ultimately they're scared, and they want to keep Parliament as a two-party closed shop where third progressive voices don't get a say. One of the things is that potentially it might backfire for him as people understand that you've got two choices in Melbourne. You either do what Tony Abbott wants or you vote Greens.
What do you make of both leaders' commitments now to not do any deals post-election? Mr Abbott in particular is saying that he wants a clear majority, that the hung parliament failed to be effective. How did you view it?
Well, Tony Abbott and his Liberal Party doesn't have a majority in parliament. They're only able to potentially win with the support of another minority party called the Nationals that gets less votes than the Greens, and yet that seems to be perfectly acceptable for him. And on the Kevin Rudd side of the agenda, is he really saying that, for example, if it came down to his friend Bob Katter's vote, that he'd rather go back to the election rather than talk with people sitting on the crossbenches? I mean, I think this is just arrogant and high-handed. At the end of the day, it's incumbent on those leaders and the other political parties to respect what the Australian people put up as a result of the election.
Finally, Mr Bann, I appreciate that you're taking all this as a compliment. You may have no other choice. You're saying it won't damage your chances. What do you say about betting agencies like Sporting Bet saying that its punters are now betting on the Greens winning zero seats in the lower house? The best odds for that outcome, zero seats.
Well, a Galaxy poll that was released in my seat of Melbourne a week or so ago suggested our primary vote was in the order of 48%, well above what the analysts are saying would be needed for us to win the seat in our own right. I'm not taking my guidance from what the bookmakers might say, who are trying to make money out of elections. I'm taking my guidance from what people in Melbourne are telling me.
Mr Bant, thanks very much for your time.
Thanks very much.